In this short presentation, we're going to look at series connected resistors and link it to Ohm's law. If the multimeter shown was set to measure resistance, therefore set to ohms, and we measured the resistor to have a resistive value of 10 ohms, and then we were to apply a voltage across that resistor of say 60 volts and reset the multimeter now to measure current, it would work out the calculation which we've looked at in Ohm's law. So current equals voltage divided by resistance. Therefore, the 60 volts applied across the resistor divided by the 10 ohms of resistance would show a current of 6 amperes. We have now added a second resistor and have two resistors connected in series. The total resistance in a series circuit is the sum of the individual resistors. So if we label them R1 and R2, the total resistance RT equals R1 plus R2. If both resistors were of 10 ohms, as suggested in the first part of the presentation, the total resistance in circuit would be 10 plus 10, giving you a total resistance of 20 ohms. If we applied the same voltage as previously stated of 60 volts and set the multimeter to measure current, it would work out the calculation of Ohm's law. Current equals voltage divided by resistance, in this case total resistance. So the current in circuit would be 60 volts divided by 20 ohms, giving you a circuit current of 3 amperes. In a series circuit, current is common to all parts of the circuit, therefore 3 amps will flow through resistor 1 and resistor 2. We can go on and work out the potential difference or voltage that would appear across each of the resistors. As both resistors are valued the same at 10 ohms, we would only need to work out the value of voltage across one of the resistors in order to find out what they would be across both. Again, using Ohm's law, we know the circuit current is 3 amps and we know the value of resistor 1 is 10 ohms. Therefore, we can do V equals I times R. Therefore, the voltage across resistor 1 is 3 times 10. The voltage across resistor 1 is 30 volts. The second resistor is valued the same, therefore we wouldn't need to calculate that one, but we could if it was different, and therefore add the two together to give us our total voltage. So if 30 volts appears across resistor 1, and they're both of the same value, 30 volts in this case would appear across resistor 2, giving us a total voltage of the supply voltage of 60 volts. If we had three resistors connected in circuit and we set our multimeter to measure resistance, it would measure the total circuit resistance. If each of the individual resistors were rated at 10 ohms as stated in the first part of the presentation, the total resistance in circuit would be 10 plus 10 plus 10, giving you a total resistance of 30 ohms for this circuit. If we once again apply a voltage of 60 volts to these three 10 ohm resistors connected in series and change our multimeter to measure current, it will do the Ohm's law calculation for us. It would do I equals V divided by R. So current is found by voltage divided by total resistance. Therefore, current equals 60 divided by 30. In other words, the current equals 2 amperes. Once again, the potential difference or voltage that appears across each of the resistors can also be worked out. We know the circuit current is 2 amps. We know the value of resistor 1, 2 and 3 are equal at 10 ohms each. So we'll only have to work this out once and add these voltages together. So if we do the voltage V equals current times resistance or I times R, we would do 2 times 10 to equal 20 volts appearing across resistor 1. As resistor 2 and 3 are of equal value of resistance, they also would have 20 volts appearing across those. We add them together, we get the total voltage. The total voltage would be 20 plus 20 plus 20, giving us our supply voltage of 60 volts.